Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing. It means a lot to us. In today's video, we'll show you how to remove or replace knock sensor. Okay, on Kia Forte. In some markets, is known as Kia K3 or Kia Cerato. Okay, so this is where the knock sensor is located. We'll need to remove the intake in order to get to it. Stay with us, we'll do that. But before we start, let me tell you, we have more than 200 videos taking the whole car apart. Anything from engine work to door panels, window regulators. So please guys, subscribe, many more videos will come. So let's go ahead and start on it now. So you can see the front end of the vehicle is up in the air because we will need to work underneath as well in order to remove the intake. So if you need any of the parts and tools we use, check out. They will be listed in the description of the video below. So we will need to remove the engine cover first. After that, we will need to remove the top of the air filter box. Okay, now right here, you can see that's the intake hose. There is a bracket. We need to use a 10mm socket. We'll get it loose, that way we can unhook the hose from the throttle body. So we can see now, on the throttle body you'll find one hose going in, one going out. This is antifreeze coolant. So what we'll do, we'll disconnect the throttle body. By disconnecting the throttle body, okay, we don't need to drain the coolant. Otherwise, you have to drain the coolant and you have to disconnect these hoses. So we will have to disconnect two hoses, this one here and this one there, or you can remove them from the intake, but it's a little bit more complicated. So we'll recommend going from here and careful not to break that line because it's plastic past the hose. Next we'll disconnect the wiring harness from the intake. Okay, you can help it with a screwdriver to pull the wires up. Okay, how you do that? Okay, you can see those. You just grab them with a screwdriver, push them towards each other and you pull it out. Disconnecting the wires one by one. So now we need to go ahead and disconnect that wiring harness, okay, right here. Okay, you can see this wire and the one over here. You can disconnect them from underneath as well. And that way you have to make sure that the wires are not attached to the intake anymore. So now there is one bolt with a 12mm socket, guys. It's kind of like down there. Once we remove the intake, we'll show you exactly where it is. It's hard to get the camera in there to exactly show you the location of the bolt, but once we remove the intake, I'll be able to show you really good. And make sure you stay until the end because there is something very important you have to do when you remove or replace intake. Okay, this is the bolt. We removed it. Now, 12mm deep socket is very convenient with extension and we will need to remove a few bolts. two on top are actually nuts. So you can see the intake is out of the way now. We can get to the NOx sensor. Okay, and we need 12 millimeter socket, and those are usually pretty tight. Only one bolt holding them. Okay, now we need to disconnect the wire. Okay, you can see where it goes down there. Okay, came out of the clip there, we'll disconnect the wire here. So on this one you have to pull the piece up, disconnect it, and now we need to disconnect it from that metal holder here. Now on the inside there, okay, there is one, okay, one little hole, round hole, get a small screwdriver, press in, and at the same time pull it out. Okay, that's the tooth. Okay, that's the two that you need to disconnect. Okay, you can see this thing, you press in and you pull the connector out. Okay, and this is your NOx sensor out of the Kia. So this is the new sensor we will be installing in reverse order. We took it apart. If you want to see if yours is bad, there is a way to test them, not 100% accurate, but it's on the channel, so maybe that can save you a few bucks instead of buying a new sensor if you don't need one. So let's go ahead and install the new one now. Okay, we'll need to connect the wire. So just make sure that the wire is connected all the way. It's tight, because if it's loose, it's going to give a call to the computer that it has knocking, when it actually doesn't. Okay. And from that point on, guys, we just have to go ahead and put the intake together in reverse order. We took it apart, not very complicated procedure. Just everything in reverse order. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe, guys, for more videos.